that the number of industrial actions we witness in the medical profession does not speak well for the country.
Hope for permanent end to industrial unrest in the health sector as President Jonathan pledges to implement recommendation of Committee on Interprofessionals Relationship.
It is not constitution amended to serve any particular section or a constitution that will be obeyed by a section of this country or by a group of Nigerians.
Expectations high on constitutional review as states submit resolutions to National Assembly. And new commemorative 100 Naira notes begin circulation. A very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us for NTA Network News. I am Elizabeth Banu. The incessant conflicts and unhealthy rivalries among medical professionals have caught the attention of the federal government as President Goodluck Jonathan pledges to implement the recommendation of the Presidential Committee of Experts on Interprofessional Relationships in the Public Health Sector. Correspondent Segun Lawle reports that the president directed that the white paper on it be issued with a view to ending the conflict.
The Special Presidential Committee, headed by the former Secretary to the Government of the Federation, Jahali Ahmed, was put in place in September 2013 to look into the challenges of the nation's public health sector, as frequently occasioned by unhealthy rivalry by different professional cadres in the sector, thereby compromising efficiency and effectiveness in healthcare delivery. President Goodluck Jonathan, while receiving the report of the committee, which commenced operations 8 months after inauguration, expressed commitment to bring an end to the conflict among public health care professionals in the country.
I feel extremely sad, and most Nigerians also appreciate that the number of industrial actions we witness in the medical profession does not speak well for the country. Secretary to government, this report, between the first and the second week of January, the white paper must be out. This report will be a major achievement in government, a great history, that it will stabilize the medical profession so that this daily, weekly, monthly industrial actions will be limited.
The committee had discovered 50 areas of conflict, which among others included organizational management issue, leadership and teamwork, remuneration and governance, and therefore recommended that the National Healthcare Commission should superintend all tertiary institutions and regulatory agencies in the public health sector.
Governance issues consist of cross-cutting matters affecting the entire spectrum of the federal public service and in some respect the state services, which needed to be addressed in order to improve the quality of public administration in Nigeria. It will also help eliminate the recurrence of such issues in the other sectors of the federal public service for better performance, productivity, and service delivery.
President Jonathan also had an audience with the Super Eagles captain, Joseph Yobe, who is now championing the course of sensitizing the grassroots on the efforts of the Jonathan-led administration in youth development and transformation.
I'm here to endorse Mr. President, His Excellency, the President of our great nation, Dr. Goodluck Billy Jonathan, for his re-election. He has done so well. So as a youth, I stand for the youth. As a youth, you know, he has his second time. He deserves another time to complete or to push forward the good work that he has started. I do believe in this legacy of the transformation agenda, and that's why this World to World initiative is building on that legacy.
In the State House, Shola Wole, NTA News.
State Houses of Assembly have voted overwhelmingly for the strengthening of the government institutions for effective service delivery to Nigerians as well as their financial independence. These are some of the highlights of the amendments approved by the lawmakers in the fourth alteration bill of the 1999 Constitution submitted to the National Assembly. Adamu Sambu has details.
The German Conference of State Assembly Speakers, Mr. Samuel Ikon, presented a document containing their resolutions to the Senate President David Mark. Apart from agreeing to their financial independence, the state lawmakers also voted overwhelmingly to separate the office of the Attorney General of the Federation and that of the Justice Minister. Although the documents are yet to be analyzed, indications are that local government autonomy did not scale through.
We urge that this process be a continuous one, as sections not agreed to today may find relevance for such in the future.
The Senate President David Mark, who commended the state assemblies for demonstrating unwavering commitment in consolidating the gains of democracy, made a case for operators of the Constitution to make it work in the best interests of Nigeria.
It is not constitution amended to serve any particular section or a constitution that will be obeyed by a section of this country or by a group of Nigerians. It is a constitution that is binding on all of us.
The legislature has long recognized that to secure the future of Nigeria, it must produce a constitution that will meet the aspirations and needs of Nigerians and that which will facilitate national development in an equitable manner.
Whatever the outcome of these returns from the states, we will accept it as the inevitable consequences of running a federation where the input of the states is a critical requirement.
Meanwhile, receiving his new national identity card from the Director General of the National Identity Management Commission, Chris Oyemena, the Senate President said the biometric cards would guide government in accurate planning, check insecurity, as well as the influx of illegal immigrants. The Director General of the National Identity Management Commission, Chris Oyemenon, explained that the new national identity card is secured, personalized, and could be used as credit card. In Abuja, Adamu Sambo, NTA News.
The Election Petition Tribunal sitting in Abuja over the Ekiti State governorship election has dismissed the petition filed by the All Progressives Congress challenging the process that led to the election of Governor Ayodele Fayoshi. Correspondent Aliu Tukur reports.
The petition was dismissed in its entirety by Chairman of the Tribunal, Justice Muhammad Ibrahim Surajo, on the grounds that the petitioner failed to substantiate the allegations with enough evidence. Justice Surajo, in his judgment, held that the All Progressives Congress failed to prove the allegations raised against Governor Fayoshe, such as certificate forgery and others. The APC also alleged that the elections was heavily militarized, which led to the arrest of its members and stoppage of its supporters from casting their votes, among others. The tribunal, however, said the petitioner did not provide evidence such as the names of persons arrested and deterred from voting.
This was one petition that should never have been filed because ab initio, even from the pleadings, it was so empty.
We really commend the way the judges display their duties.
In another development, Justice Hussaini Baba of the FCT High Court had stepped aside the ex parte order aimed at stopping the Akwa Ibom PDP from submitting the details of its governorship candidate to the INEC, therefore paving the way for PDP to go ahead and submit the name of its aspirant before the deadline. In Abuja, Aliu Tukur, NTA News.
Still on the political scene, political violence no doubt affects the growth and consolidation of a healthy democratic culture. As the 2015 elections draw near, Chinedu Obike reports on the need to curb this unhealthy development in Nigeria.
The resurgence of political activities in Nigeria often comes with violence, which perhaps explains the reason for the series of peace summits recently organized by the Independent National Electoral Commission for critical stakeholders. As election year 2015 draws near, the need for a violence-free environment becomes even more crucial.
I still think that the greatest problem that we have with political violence, even before and after elections, is the rhetoric. And there I would blame the politicians.
I do advise the fellow youth of, like me, patriotic youth of this country, that we should not be used by selfish politicians.
Though elective office seekers are often blamed for mobilizing the youths, some politicians would rather pursue justice through legal avenues.
It does not matter how any person feels out there. There are so many other platforms one can achieve his political aspiration. It's a function of the disposition of the people, the constituents.
So there's no way we can stand and say that our people should go into violence. There's no way we can wake up and say, no, let's go and fight and fight. We will not do that.
Now, I've also told politicians, my fellow politicians, that this business is not a do or die. If it's not your turn today, maybe it might be yours tomorrow.
While some may choose the peace option, which promotes dialogue and decency, others easily resort to violence, often described as a democratic impediment.
If it's a good thing, let them bring their children, give them the arms, give them the machete to fight their opponents.
The issue of unemployment must be tackled, because if the youths are gainfully employed, they have less time to get into trouble spots.
While all are unanimous on the need for peace, many believe that for it to work, Nigerians must be determined and committed to achieving a violence-free nation as 2015 approaches. In Abuja, Chinedu Obike.
One-time governor of Imo State, Ikede Oakim, has appealed to his supporters to remain calm as all efforts are on to correct the wrongs at the just-concluded governorship primaries in that state in which he supposedly lost out. Mr. Oakim, who addressed his supporters, some of whom are artisans who purchased his nomination form and turned out en masse to welcome him from Abuja, said the issue will be resolved, urging them not to resort to violence as the PDP is a house that nobody can destroy.
Purely political problem that requires intervention at the highest level.
The state publicity secretary of the party, Kensington Nwachukwu, also assured the gathering that the party will use its internal conflict resolution mechanism to amicably resolve the crisis arising from the primaries. President Imo Artisans Association said the shortchanging of their preferred candidate is not acceptable to them. The fundraising dinner in honor of President Goodluck Jonathan ahead of the presidential campaign for the 2015 elections will hold at the Banquet Hall State House this Saturday evening at 7 o'clock. Chairman of the PDP Fundraising Dinner Committee, Professor Jerry Gana, disclosed this while speaking on a special political update program. He says the dinner will attract all party stakeholders and other supporters of Dr. Goodluck Jonathan's re-election in 2015. The program, tagged Special Political Update, comes up tonight at 10 o'clock on the NTA Network service. Join us. A bit on security now. Director of Defense Information, Major General Chris Olukolade, has confirmed the killing of some residents of Gumsuri in Borno State by insurgents. Statement signed by Major General Chris Olukolade reiterated that the troops are on patrol duty by air and land forces in Gumsuri in search of the terrorists, while the defense headquarters is verifying the reported abductions in the community in view of claims by unidentified sources being quoted. The director assured that terrorists will not have freedom of action in the area as counter-terrorism campaign is being intensified. And the current security challenges facing Nigeria can only be addressed with some homegrown solutions instead of depending on foreign allies. Former Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Azubike Ihejuwika, made the assertion at the second memorial for the former National Security Advisor, General Andrew Azazi, who died in a plane crash in December 2012. Mia Ogidi reports.
It was a solemn gathering to reflect on the outstanding qualities of the late four-star general Andrew Owe Azazi. But being a gathering well attended by top military and civilians, it turned out to be a common ground for the cross-fertilization of ideas on how to curb insurgency in Nigeria.
You can only build power. You cannot buy power. It does not matter whether America is your friend or Britain is your friend or what Ghana is your friend. You must build it yourself.
However, the captivating security discourse did not redirect the focus of the gathering from its primary purpose, that is, an arts exhibition titled Nostalgia in Honor of Late General Azazi.
When you see the art, you think of him, very incredibly classy, and you really don't think a military man would be this classy. We thank Ambassador Igali for putting this together.
As I sat there,
I just felt that he was sitting somewhere behind and enjoying it too.
That it is not the length of life, but it's the quality of life. And I think that's the message for us who are still alive and for our children that coming after us to continue to build this great nation.
Guests took time out to visit the various exhibition stands.
Late General Owe Azazi was a lover of art, so this art stand in his honor will stay here for 7 days, where people of like minds will come and visit. In Abuja, Mie Ogidi, NTN.
The commemoration of 100 Naira banknote recently unveiled by President Goodluck Jonathan went into circulation this Friday. Accordingly, all branches of the central bank have been directed to begin the issuance of the currency in their respective locations. The commemorative note, which is embedded with features to assist the visually impaired recognize genuine notes, also has other security features easily identifiable through look, feel, and tilt of the currency note. Senate President David Mark has made a passionate appeal to political office seekers to allow the wishes of the people anchored on the rule of law prevail ahead of the 2015 elections. Speaking at the 2014 Christmas carols at St. Mulumba Chaplaincy, Abuja, Senator Mark cautioned politicians to beware that only the mandate of the people would be sustainable. National Assembly correspondent Adam Sambu reports.
The 2014 Christmas carol provided an opportunity for the faithful to thank God for his blessings in their lives and the nation, as well as offer prayers for a more prosperous year in 2015. The Senate President, who spoke extensively on the forthcoming elections, said violence, intimidation or rancor should not be part of politics. He said people should be allowed to freely make their choices without manipulation in an atmosphere of peace.
Without peace, there can be no democracy. Without peace, we cannot have election. Without peace, we cannot be leaders. Let God touch our hands, touch our hearts, so that we can accept his will.
The Catholic Archbishop of Abuja, John Cardinal Oenaekong, also spoke in the same vein, urging politicians to make peaceful coexistence the focal point of their campaigns.
We are going to continue begging Nigerians between now and February. Beg you, peace. We shouldn't take our peace for granted. And let no one spoil God's plan for all of us.
Prayers were offered for victims of violent crimes in the northeastern part of the country, as well as God's divine intervention towards healing the troubled nations of the world. In Abuja, Adamu Sambu, NTN.
First Lady Dame Patience Jonathan has again appealed to Nigerians to respect the sanctity of human life and continue to love one another. The First Lady made the appeal at the funeral of Michael Anyamusigwe in Nkwere, Imo State. State House correspondent Makut Simon Macham reports.
The funeral service for Michael Anyamusigwe was held at the St. Thomas Catholic Church in Nkwere, Imo State, where the Bishop of Olu Diocese, Augustine Ukoma, officiated. He described the late Michael Anyamusigwe as a man who impacted his generation and challenged Nigerians to use their lives in doing good and fulfilling the mandate of God. Then Patience Jonathan, in a remark, regretted the murder of Michael Anyamusigwe by armed robbers, saying Nigerians must learn to protect the sanctity of life and look out for each other. She commiserated with the family and asked them to take solace in the fact that he served the family well and contributed to the development of Nigeria.
Our young brother and friend was a devoted Christian, a patriotic Nigerian, and a community leader who put in his best to make life better for those who came in contact with him.
Imo Imo State Governor Rochas Okorocha joined the First Lady to eulogize Michael Anyamosigwe and reminded Nigerians that no ambition or search for wealth was enough to take someone's life. Late Michael Anyamosigwe, before his death, was the Honorary Consul of the Republic of Malawi to Nigeria and the Coordinator General of the Anyamosigwe Foundation. From Nkwere in Imo State, Makut Simon Macham.
Federal government releases 200 billion naira to universities as Federal Road Safety Management moves to make all its staff landlords. We'll bring you details after this timeout.
Form the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
Change is never easy. It was not easy for Dr. Martin Luther King when Prime Minister Lee Kuan Yew transformed Singapore from third world to first world. It was not easy. They stoned him. It was not easy for Nelson Mandela.
I, Barack Hussein Obama.
It was not easy for Barack Obama. Nothing worthwhile ever is. Dr. Martin Luther King did it. Prime Minister Lee Kuan Yew did it. Nelson Mandela did it. Barack Obama did it. Good Luck Jonathan is doing it. He is transforming Nigeria. Mr. President, keep doing it. We who are with you are so many more than those who are against you. A message from protectors of Nigerian posterity.
Share the joy of a sinless connection. VisaPhone, your passport to reach the world.
Looking for this?
Mommy, you're the best.
Can you see it the way that I'm feeling?
You always know what's best, Mom.
All I ever really wanted is here with me. It's my family.
Now that's different.
It's the same Gino tomato paste, but in a convenient new pack.
Expensive?
Not at all. It costs even less.
Mom always knows what's best.
Thank you.
The family's always happy with Gino. The times we have here, good moments we share. Gino truly cares.
Good people of Nigeria, ours is a great country. We may have been ravaged by the tragedies of civil war, corruption, and new terrorism.
Let us, as good citizens of our great and beloved Nigeria, unite behind our president, Goodluck Jonathan, to eradicate terrorism and corruption, to make Nigeria safer, stronger, and better.
God has blessed Nigeria with a tolerant and listening president. We cannot risk dictatorship now. Let us, through Christmas, match safe and secure in love into the new year of hope, promise, and destiny. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, good people of Nigeria. God bless Nigeria.
Vote Goodluck Jonathan and Namadi Sambo for 2015.
Vote PDP.
Courtesy, Transformation Ambassadors of Nigeria, TAN.
Johnny M2, 28 days standby time. Johnny, to be needed, to be loved.
Over the last 16 years, our great party, the PDP, has been at the forefront of transforming Nigeria. Men and women elected on the platform of our great party have been changing the look of states across Nigeria and improving the lives of their people. At the national level, projects and initiatives by our presidents have seen huge improvements in infrastructure and in agriculture, human capital development, youth, women, and other aspects of our national development. In 16 years, we have attracted unprecedented foreign direct investments to Nigeria, supported and grown our entertainment industry, and reorganized our banking sector and improved the economy. We remain committed to the total transformation of Nigeria. As we prepare for the 2015 elections, we are calling on all party faithful, friends, and well-wishers to donate generously to support our party at the PDP fundraising dinner. Date, 20th December 2014. Venue, Banquet Hall Presidential Villa. Time, 7 p.m. prompt. Come support the largest political party in Africa to ensure our credible men and women across Nigeria continue the good work of transforming Nigeria. PDP!
Power to the people! Patrician Council of Nigeria Headquarters, Abuja, and the Federal Ministry of Education cordially invites education stakeholders to the public presentation of Teachers Professional Qualifying Examination Benchmarks by Malam Ibrahim Shekaro, CON, Honorable Minister of Education, and Professor Viola Onwuoluri, Honorable Minister of State for Education, under the distinguished chairmanship of Professor Greg O. Iwu, OON, Chairman, TRC and Governing Board, Special Guest of Honor, Senator Bala A. Mohammed, Honorable Minister, Federal Capital Territory, Keynote Speaker, Professor Uche Azikiwe, University of Nigeria, Nsukka. Date, Monday, December 22, 2014. Time, 10 a.m. prompt. Venue, Rockview Hotel Royal, Ademola Adetokunba Crescent, Wuse-2, Abuja. Professor Addison Mark Wokocha, TRCN Registrar, Chief Executive, announces.
Change. Those who make history must first ruffle some feathers.
Look at us.
Good luck, Abele Jonathan, championing the change we can see.
At us. We changing. Nigeria is changing.
On my watch, we have witnessed high national economic growth rates, steady improvements, and expansion of national infrastructure.
What God has joined, let no man separate. God loves Nigeria. Unite and continue with good luck. A message from protectors of Nigerian posterity.
We begin this segment with a bit on education. The federal government has released 200 billion naira intervention fund to be disbursed by federal and state universities across the federation. Education Minister Malam Ibrahim Shekaro announced this at a one-day sensitization retreat on the implementation of needs assessment report in Abuja. Franca Uzoma-Olua reports.
The 200 billion naira released by the federal government is part of the 1.3 trillion naira intervention fund, a fallout of the federal government ASU agreement on the revitalization of Nigerian public universities. The retreat is therefore designed to sensitize participants on the guidelines and procedures required in the implementation of the needs assessment report.
You are expected to comply with the federal government due process in all your procurement processes, as contained in the Public Procurement Act of 2007. The responsibility for due process for works, goods and services rests with the procurement entities.
The release of 200 billion naira is in line with federal government's commitment to address the infrastructural gaps and teaching needs in public universities. In Abuja, Franca Uzoma-Olua, NTA News.
A book on the 1999 Constitution for Children has been launched in Abuja. The book is expected to give children a formal and better understanding on the nitty-gritty of the Nigerian Constitution.
Although the book is meant for children, attendants at this first phase launch are journalists who are required to give the book the much needed awareness. The book, which is a children's handbook on Nigeria's 1999 constitution, breaks it down into a simpler form for better understanding for children. The pictorial illustration plus the simple text language says it all. Children, as the saying goes, are the future leaders of tomorrow, hence the need to be better informed about the Nigerian law. The book reviewer, Rit Gwan, a journalist, said the book couldn't have come at a better time in view of the fact that children nowadays are more interested in other things than understanding the laws of the environment.
It's a lighter copy or a lighter edition of the Constitution that allows children to see the Constitution as it is. That is why we have seven chapters just as it is in the Constitution.
The book publishers, Premier Information Services, say the concept for the book was based on patriotism from the roots, which are the children.
It would be good for our children, our wards, and even adults to be fully acquainted with what the content of the Nigerian Constitution. But that is what will now empower you to become a good citizen of this great nation, Nigeria.
The proper launch of the book is expected to have in attendance children drawn from various geopolitical zones of the country. In Abuja, Bidemi Adewumi, NTA News.
Following the presidential flag-off of the National Power Apprenticeship Scheme, the first batch of beneficiaries, mostly graduates in the engineering field, have started their induction course in Abuja preparatory to the main training with effect from January 2015. Mia Ogidi attended the opening session of the induction course and now reports.
The nation's power sector no doubt lacks the needed manpower to handle the technical issues in the sector, as most of the old arms have been disengaged following the privatization of the sector.
There's a difference between education and skills.
These young Nigerians who are currently undergoing orientation for a one-year training under the National Power Sector Apprenticeship Scheme are to fill this gap.
The success and sustainability of the gains already made in the power sector can only be sustained if we have the skilled Nigerians who can work in the sector.
We encourage these young people to give it their best. You know, some young people just want to occupy time. This is not time for occupying time. Put your whole being into this learning process.
The 7,400 youths who are expected to undergo their one-year training in different parts of the country after the orientation seemed well prepared for the task ahead.
With what we've heard today, we'll be able to be better Nigerians, be able to help Nigeria to move forward.
You know, if they are able to push these new engineers into the power system, there will be a positive change in no distant time into the power system.
More Nigerian engineers and other technicians are expected to benefit in subsequent batches. In Abuja, Mie Ogidi, NTA News.
Shelter is one of the three basic human needs. In Nigeria, a housing deficit of over 18 million is not helping matters. So when a program that will provide housing comes on stream, there is excitement. Yohan Kwange tells us about one government agency set to provide its employees a place to lay their heads.
Ask any civil servant to state his or her three major needs, and you will most likely hear housing, housing, and housing. That is how much housing has become an issue, especially in the Federal Capital Territory. Government agencies with high premium and staff welfare are therefore responding to this need. The management of the Federal Road Safety Corps has just come up with another housing scheme that will make all marshals and officers potential landlords nationwide. The scheme, unveiled in Abuja, is tagged One Staff, One House, with a take-off figure of 20,000 houses. The Corps Marshal, Boboyo Oyeyemi, says the scheme will enhance productivity and ease staff anxiety arising from accommodation difficulties.
In terms of housing, it is probably the basic needs of life, because you need to put your head somewhere after the day's work. And if you don't have your own house, you must pay rent. And if you don't pay rent, that means the house belongs to you after a period of time.
This initiative obviously delights the Secretary to the Government of the Federation, Anyim Pius Anyim, who was represented at the ceremony by Dr. Habiba Lawal.
It is gratifying to note that the Federal Road Safety Corps has continued to demonstrate its policy of staff welfare through endurable policies capable of motivating staff for higher productivity, as evidenced by the concept of the 20,000 housing project being unveiled today.
When the project begins to yield fruits, one wish you will likely have is to be a staff of the Federal Road Safety Corps. In Abuja, Yohan Kwange, NTA News.
You're watching NTA Network News. Ademola Adewoye is in our Lagos Center with stories making headlines in that zone. Compliments of the season to you, Ademola. You're on.
Elizabeth, good evening and welcome to Lagos. The Nigerian Bar Association, NBA, has entered into a strategic partnership with the Leadway Assurance Company Limited for the provision of life insurance cover packages for lawyers in Nigeria. Both parties sealed this deal with a signing of Memorandum of Understanding in Lagos. NBA President Augustine Alige, SAN, signed for the NBA, while Executive Director of Leadway Assurance, Adetola Adegbayi, signed for Leadway Assurance. Viera Chimwaba witnessed and reports that Leadway Assurance Company Limited is now the official insurance company for the NBA.
The provision of life insurance cover by the present administration of the NBA is the first of its kind in the history of the Nigerian Bar. It is meant to improve the welfare of members. It is also in recognition of the many challenges confronting lawyers, as well as in fulfillment of the promise made by the NBA President Austin Alege to promote and protect the interests of members.
When they have accidents or the inevitable death occurs, their families are left in a state of penury. It is for this singular reason that we took it upon ourselves to look for an insurance platform for all lawyers. It was best that the association pays the premium.
It is a life insurance policy that ensures that members are equally covered for critical illness, they're covered for permanent disability as a result of accident, and they are covered for medical expenses also as a result of accident.
The premium for the insurance policy shall be fully funded by the NBA with funds realized from payment of annual bar practicing fees. However, the insurance policy will be available to lawyers who have paid their annual bar practicing fees. All insurance claims will also be processed directly by the insurance company within 7 days of notification. NBA President Austin Alege said Leadway Assurance's proven track record of performance informed its choice, as Leadway Assurance Company Limited is now the official insurance company for the NBA.
Also today, the Nigerian Bar Association, NBA, signed another Memorandum of Understanding with Access Bank, PLC, for a regulated legal practice as well as provision of seamless banking services for Nigerian lawyers. The strategic partnership of the NBA and Access Bank come with the provision of Visa Affinity cards for Nigerian lawyers. The NBA President, Austin Alige, SAN, who signed for NBA, said it is a sign of better things to come. Group Managing Director Herbert Wigwe signed for Access Bank. Viera Chuamba reports that it is a new dawn for both parties in the quest for regulated legal practice in Nigeria.
The array of products and services which Access Bank PLC has in stock for Nigerian lawyers include personalized affinity cards to be used on e-payment platforms for collection and remittance of sums and levies due to NBA in its 109 branches. These services, NBA President said, will assist the present administration of the NBA in fulfilling its mandate and promise to properly regulate the practice of law in Nigeria.
This card carries the lawyer's name, lawyer's enrollment number, and the picture. And it's a payment card, it's a prepaid card. You can pay your practicing fees, you can pay your branch dues. It brings monumental benefit to all members of our association.
The card which we're providing is an affinity card. And so it serves several purposes for lawyers. It would help them in terms of cutting down conference costs, because Access will be taking responsibility for several of those costs, of those conferences which they would have, not just in 2015, for at least for the next 5 years.
NBA President Austin Alege said
The innovation will assist MBA in the fight against the influx of quacks in the Nigerian legal system, as only fully paid-up members of the MBA will be issued with the Visa Affinity Cards sponsored by Access Bank. The group managing director of the bank, Hubert Nwigwe, described the Visa Affinity Card as a multi-purpose and versatile card which supports lawyers' many programs. Access Bank is expected to take advantage of the MBA huge membership base of over 120 lawyers to exclusively advertise and market its goods and services to lawyers. In Lagos, Viera Chumuba, NTA News.
And now to business news with Ameshi Piers.
Thank you for joining us on the business news segment. Nigerians wishing to be with their loved ones from Lagos this Christmas may have to pay more. This is because of the increase in transport fares by most of the transport operators in Lagos. NTA Business News visited some parks in Lagos. Here's the report. Like every other festive period, the Christmas holiday provides an opportunity for most Nigerians, especially workers, to be with their loved ones. During such period, more people travel to various parts of the country, either by air or road. NTA Business News investigations revealed that transport fares to the southeast from Lagos by bus shot up by almost 15%.
I guess it's not even gone up yet. It's going to go up more than that because of the fuel situation.
People are much traveling this year more than last year. And last year the price was like lower. In fact, we are having the challenge of no bus right now. Though we are paid, but the buses are already exhausted.
A trip to Akwa Ibom State from Lagos, which cost 3,500 naira during the period under review, is between 4,500 and 5,000 naira. Those traveling to major cities in the southeast, like Onitsha and Owerri, with the luxury buses, paid between 6,000 and 7,000 naira, as against 5,000 naira passengers paid the previous year.
Like from Enugu, they dispatch the drivers empty from Enugu to Lagos. They don't carry anybody. They come empty, so they don't come with passengers. That is why the fare is so high like that.
The rush to secure space by passengers who also gathered is compounded by the fact that most people have booked their tickets online up to the 31st of December this year. And to details of movement of stocks at the nation's capital markets. Details of transactions showed that investors bought more than 3.9 billion shares at 30.2 billion naira. Market capitalization shot up slightly to 10 trillion naira, while the all share index finished at 30,306.51 points. Seplat was the top gainer, appreciating by 12 naira 9 kobo, while 7up Bottling Company led other losers with an 8 naira 30 kobo loss. And that's business news. The news continues shortly. Thanks for watching.
50,000 naira! Free money!
This is now new.
They said they're giving away free money.
Free money!
That's money!
Madam, who's giving out free money? It's a Cherry Noodles Naira Hot promo! When you buy a carton of Cherry Noodles, you may see one or even two packs with an amount written on the sizzling sachet. Go to the nearest Cherry Noodles retail shop and collect your cash instantly!
Hurry! It's the Cherry Noodles Naira Hot promo! Cherry Noodles, love at first taste!
This Christmas, find the perfect gift for everyone you love on Nigeria's largest online mall, Konga.com.
Konga.com.
My mom told me great acting needed good health. I've played so many roles in life, but my proudest role is mother to my children and my community projects. I've achieved all this thanks to good health every day with Dettol. And to be 100% sure that my children achieve success in their life, I trust Dettol. So they don't miss a single day of good health.
Dettol. Proudly part of Nigerian health for 50 years.
Africa. Some see it as a land of challenges. We see it as a land of endless opportunities, where success comes from hard work and determination, and having a strong partner. Boxer, engineered to be stronger, engineered to last longer. Because to make it in Africa, you need to be stronger for longer. Boxer, made stronger to last longer.
I need a great deal, the best price I can get. That's why I shop on Jumia.
Quality you can trust.
The all-new Phantom Z at 52,999 naira at jumia.com.ng. Jumia, the online shop you can trust.
Katsina State government is to spend more than 100 billion naira in 2015 fiscal year. Correspondent Bashir Ibrahim Nababa reports that the budget also has an opening balance of 20 billion naira.
The budget of accomplishment is designed to achieve concrete and formidable results in the development plan of the state. The proposed budget indicates that 69% of the total estimate was for capital expenditure, while 31% goes to recurrent expenditure. Presenting the proposed budget to the state legislature, Governor Ibrahim Shoshim said 20 billion naira is for economic sector, 13 billion naira for social services, and 12 billion naira for administration. Governor Ibrahim Shoshim said the state was able to meet its financial commitment without borrowing, and express appreciation to the legislature and other relevant stakeholders for their support and cooperation.
And there is no better opportunity to express my sincere appreciation for the support you have given me to operate a government that developed, nurtured, and practiced a philosophy of service, service that you, all honorable members, have been rendering to our people.
The speaker assured this executive arm of government of continued support and cooperation by members of the State House of Assembly to enable the administration accomplish its policies and programs. In Katsina, Bashir Ibrahim Nababa, NTA News.
Minister of Interior Comrade Abba Moro has challenged the graduates of the Basic Firefighting and Rescue Course of the National Fire Academy to minimize threats arising from fire outbreak in the country. Comrade Moro gave the advice at the passing out parade of the trainees held at the National Fire Academy, Abuja. He said his passion for a virile Nigeria fire service is absolute and assured the management of the Federal Fire Service that adequate firefighting infrastructure and funding will be made available for them to carry out their statutory responsibility. The Minister of Interior assured the graduates that they will soon be deployed on enforcement of fire ordinances to minimize harmful effects of fire. Military officers, apart from being vast in defending the territorial integrity of the nation, spare time for creative writing. This was evident at the launch of three books. They're entitled Nigerian Air War in Sierra Leone, authored by Air Commodore Abayomi Balogun and two others. I Will Marry You When My Father Dies, and Ejima by Captain Bolaga Tijan. Correspondent Muhammad Abdul Kadri reports.
Are often tailored towards professional and practical experiences of the writers in the frontline areas, such as the new book publicly presented on the Nigerian Air War in Sierra Leone by Air Commodore Abayomi Balogun.
And should publish facts that will help us improve our tactics and operations.
Air Commodore Balogun, from the cockpit of the call sign Aggressor 08, explained the need to domesticate the experiences of the wars in Liberia and Sierra Leone to win the counter-insurgency war in the Northeast.
Essence of our mistakes of yesteryears can be used to prevent problems ahead.
In the same vein, the books on creative writings by Captain Gbolaga Tijan, unveiled by the representative of the Chief of Army Staff, Corps Commander, Nigerian Army Education Corps, Major General Sunday Adebayo, examines marriage institution from legal perspective, while Ijima is a local dialect for twins.
We're highly impressed by what the officer has done to be able to author two books at a time.
So I try to create a legal remedy to breach or promise to marry, which people have been shying away from.
The reviewers of the books describe them as scholarly and must read for all by literary-minded people in the military, paramilitary, and academics.
The first book by the author, Captain Gbolaga Tijan, is The Making of a Soldier. From the Army Headquarters Command Officers Mess, Abuja, Muhammad Abdelkader, NTN News.
The chief imam of Ansaruddin Mosque, Abuja, Ustaz Musa Olaofe, has called on Muslims to remain united and work together towards the promotion of peace and development in Nigeria. The imam made the call while delivering a sermon during the 2-rakat Friday prayer. Aliu Kabir has details.
Quoting several verses from the Quran in a bid to buttress his point, Imam Musa Olaofe said, "The true believers from the side of God are those who obeyed him while on earth and leave good legacies to be emulated for the desired peace."
On the hadith of the Prophet that says, every one of us will become history one day. We should try to become good history. Let all of us come together under one umbrella, and that's the umbrella of unity. That is, we should be thinking how God will promote us in Nigeria.
He enjoined Muslims to remain as one indivisible entity.
The love, understanding, perseverance, so that all of us will come together as one family, so that we can be able to make Nigeria great. To make Nigeria great is not the duty of one person. It's a collective responsibility that everybody needs to carry along.
The imam also called on Nigerians to at all times pray for the country to overcome the current security challenges. In Abuja, Aliu Kabir, NTA News.
Senior Special Assistant to the President on Youth and Student Matters, Jude Imagwe, has thanked Nigerian students for their faith in President Goodluck Jonathan and their commitment to the President's re-election in 2015. Mr. Imagwe was speaking at the first Jude Imagwe annual lecture series instituted by the University of Abuja Students Union. Kenneth Nanim reports.
The presidential advisor asked the students to take the Jonathan re-election project to the next level by canvassing for him. He promised that government will continue to ensure the provision of a conducive atmosphere for learning at all levels.
They remain paramount in the heart of government. They remain a first chance burner in the heart of Mr. President. And the President has declared and directed that all campuses be maximally protected and all students enjoy full security during stay on campuses. He's counting on your support, he's counting on your prayers, he's believing you join him to sustain a new Nigeria, and above it all, you join him to consolidate a Nigeria that will be the envy.
The President Student Union Government, Olajengbesi Pelumi, thanked Comrade Jude Magwe for his support to the union, commended President Jonathan for his fruitful intervention in the educational sector, promising that Nigerian students will deliver on their pledge to support his re-election. The Director General of the NYSC, Brigadier General Jamsin Bamidele Olawumi, who was honored, and Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Michael Aduku, asked the students to pay attention to their studies and make themselves useful members of the society. In Abuja, Kenneth Nanim, NTA News.
Upper Hand Global Tidbits and Sports. We'll be right back.
The Chairman, Board and Management of Good Homes Development Company Limited wishes to thank His Excellency Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, GCFR, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, for his unflinching support towards achieving the goal of providing affordable housing for all Nigerian workers by officially flagging off the nationwide workers' housing scheme. We also wish to thank the Minister of the Federal Capital Territory and all other ministries present at the ceremony, including the NLC and the TUC, for their full support. Our gratitude goes out to all our esteemed customers. Thank you for allowing us build your dream home.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
It doesn't matter what comes, fresh goes better in life.
With Mentos candy, crunchy outside, chewy inside. Mentos candy. Get the fresh idea.
Johnny M2, 28 days standby time. Johnny, to be needed, to be loved.
The National Agency for Food and Drug Administration and Control, NAFDAC, is working in line with the transformation agenda of the President, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, to ensure access to safe, good quality essential medicines with the World Health Organization pre-qualification of Made in Nigeria pharmaceutical products, stiffer penalties for fake drug offenders with a review of NAFDAC laws, national, regional, and international collaborations, introduction of cutting-edge technologies, including the mobile authentication service.
I'm particularly impressed with the introduction of mobile authentication service, which makes it very easy for the ordinary people themselves to be able to identify drugs that are fake.
And I urge all Nigerians, irrespective of wherever they are, to key into it.
Let us support NAFDAC to win the war against fake drugs and other unwholesome regulated products. NAFDAC, safeguarding the health of the nation.
With Chimdima Ndubisi.
Although the introduced bill on security caused serious fight at the Kenyan parliament, the president still signed it into law. The new law now gives government more powers to handle insurgency issues. And as the year gradually comes to an end, the United States President Barack Obama has held an end-of-year news conference celebrating his country's economic quick recovery after the 2008 depression. On the hacking of Hollywood's Sony Pictures comedy movie, which featured an attempt to assassinate North Korea's leader, the FBI has traced it to North Korea. On the ongoing war in Iraq, the Kurdish forces say they have retaken most territories seized by ISIL. That's Global Tidbits. Chimdima Ndubisi, NTA News.
And next is Sports Update with Ayodeji Makinde.
The week-long 2014 Referees Fitness Test, which had 600 participants, has ended in Abuja with more than 500 referees and assistants billed to officiate in the 2014-2015 football season in the Premier and National League divisions. 30 of the participants were, however, medically advised against the exercise, while 50 were unable to meet the standard prescribed by FIFA.
We want to ensure that the referees that we have assure ourselves that is healthy, that is good in good physical condition, is able to deliver technically. So they already plans early in the new year, before the season starts, to run technical courses all over the country for these referees that have succeeded.
Grade 1 referees for the Nationwide League will be tested on Sunday at approved venues in the 6 geopolitical zones headed in each by a member of the NFF Referees Committee. FIFA President Sepp Blatter has succumbed to mounting pressure on full disclosure of details of the 2018 and 2022 World Cup bid processes, which have been trailed by controversy for years now. Blatter, in a statement on Friday, said based on the recommendation from Domenico Scala, the Independent Audit and Compliance Committee chairman, he has asked the FIFA Executive Committee to vote in favor of the publication of the 2018 and 2022 inquiry report by the adjudicatory chamber. China has continued to put more sporting facilities in place in preparation for the bid to host the 2022 Winter Olympics in Beijing. The latest is Ice World Sportland in Wuxong, which is the largest in Asia with a total area of 15,000 square meters. With sports updates, Ayodeji, Makinde, NTA News.
And just before we go, remember it's your right to challenge anybody involved in unwholesome activities around you. Be security conscious. This message is from the Directorate of State Security Service. And that's NTA Network News. We thank you for watching. Do have a wonderful weekend. Good night.